a watershed?
A watershed is any area of land the water flows across or through.
Why do we call it a watershed?
Well, we call it a watershed because that's all the land that sends water to a river, a lake, or some other place.
So where's the water going?
Downhill. Hard to notice the hills here in Southwest Florida.
So let's just pretend that you guys are water drops in the clouds and you fall down to the boat ramp here. Are you going to stay on the boat ramp or are you going to roll down to the river?
Roll.
Roll down to the river, so let's roll.
Okay.
And off we roll.
I get it. The boat ramp, the rocks, the land. It's all part of the watershed. But where does the watershed begin?
The Charlotte Harbor watershed starts way up in Polk County, and it travels all the way down to Charlotte Harbor and Bonita Springs. And it covers about 4,700 square miles.
In the Charlotte Harbor watershed, there are three rivers that flow into the Charlotte Harbor estuary, the Peace River, the Myakka, and the Caloosahatchee.
We met outdoor educator Mr. Kayton Nedza early in the day at Paynes Creek Historic State Park in Hardee County.
What kind of animals live in here?
Animals? Well, there's a lot of animals that live here. Would y'all like to try to find some?
Yeah!
Sure. Okay, well, just head on over that way.
Let's go.
And we'll start getting some nets and everything and go in the water and see what we can find.
Alligators live in creeks, rivers, and lakes, so we had to be careful. Mr. Kayton had already checked the river to make sure it would be safe for us to go wading there.
Look, Mr. Kayton, look at the crawfish.
Yeah, I see him crawling around there. Let's get him up here. Oh, yeah, he's a little baby one. He'll grow up to be about 2 or 3 inches long.
Wow.
And, yeah, about that big. And they provide food for not only fish, but even things like raccoons.
Is all the little creatures in the river important to the watershed?
Yes, all of the little creatures and big creatures, too, are important because the little creatures provide food for other creatures. For example, this little spider may be eaten by a bass or possibly even a snook that might swim up from Charlotte Harbor.
Watersheds can be big or small. In the continental United States, there are 2,110 watersheds. They cross county, state, and national boundaries. All the water in the watershed ends up flowing into the same place.
Andrew and Sierra met science teacher Miss Susie Hassett and some of her student volunteers at Bunche Beach in Fort Myers to learn how the watershed impacts the estuary.
In this watershed, there are homes, farms, factories, a mall, and a marina.
Can anyone tell me what a farmer might use to help his crops grow better?
Fertilizer?
Student volunteers Hazel and Madison used a model of a watershed to show Andrew and Sierra how water flows through the land to the ocean. They found out that the water collects some nasty materials along the way.
Cars and factories drop oil, and animal droppings can pollute the water if there's too much.
You mean like dogs and cats?
Uh-huh. Too much of it can pollute the water.
So you mean that everything that is put into the ground goes to the ocean?
Yes, every last bit of it.
So that's why you have to be careful what you put on your farms and yards. It might affect you later. And remember, we have to take care of the water we all share.
Your backyard is part of a watershed. Your schoolyard is part of a watershed. And all that water sheds into the sea.
What type of fish are these?
Well, most of these are silver sides, and there are some silver Jenny Moharas as well.
But all of these are too little to eat, right?
No. Did you ever have sardines on a pizza or anchovies?
Oh, right. Is all that grass seagrass?
Yeah, there are several different kinds. The wide and flat, like a turtle's back, is turtle grass. And then there's round, like a manatee, and that's manatee grass. Do you want to feel it? And then thin and flat, like a shoal, is shoal grass.
The grasses provide food and shelter for all the baby animals. They also help to clean the water.
When it rains, the water runs across the land into the little creeks. The creeks run into the river, and the river comes out here to the ocean. And here at the ocean is the estuary. Do you know what an estuary is?
The ocean?
Close. It's at the edge of the ocean where the fresh water from the land meets the salt water from the sea, and they mix. So would you like to meet some of the babies of the estuary? These are some of the things that we found this morning. I bet you can recognize this guy.
Catfish.
Catfish is right. Did you know catfish live in freshwater and in saltwater? This guy is a sea catfish. He's got those barbels and they can taste food on the bottom with those whiskers.
Oh, wow.
So what does this look like?
A slug?
You're right. It's a sea slug. It's actually called a ragged sea hare. What do you think it might eat?
Plankton?
It'll chew on plants. It eats and eats and eats and eats all kinds of plants. So that's how it got the name sea hare. It's a lot like a hare or a rabbit that wants to eat plants.
So what's something that we can all do?
It'd be great to clean up your own mess. If you pick up after your dogs, if you compost the waste from your house, and if you're careful about what you put on your yard, it keeps the water we share nice and clean.
Okay, so we'll do that.
Thank you, that'd be great.
Keeping the watershed clean means we all get to enjoy the rivers, creeks, the estuary, and the ocean.